Now, I believe that on one side of this debate, we have Sudha Ramalingam, advocate and human rights activist from Chennai. We have Kajal Menon, co-founder of Leher, a child rights organization, in our studios in Mumbai. And I believe also on that side is Aryaman Sundaram, though I will not preempt his line of argument. On the other side, seeking a change in the law and tougher laws against juveniles, Vani Tripathi of the BJP and Rahul Narvekar of the Shiv Sena. Now, Aryaman Sundaram, this fellow, this juvenile, he was the most brutal of all of Nirbhaya's killers and rapists. What he did to her is beyond description. I mean, I don't even want to talk about it. But I can only say that it was a perverse mindset, an animal instinct. He was the one who actually threw her off the moving vehicle devoid of her clothes. And I'm not even saying about how he brutalized her. Now, Aryaman Sundaram, when this fellow is out on the streets of Delhi 2 years from now, we expect the people of this, women in this country, to feel safe?
Arnab, I think you've got me on the wrong side of the fence by your opening comment. I maintain, and I have always maintained, that this nonsensical age limit of so-called 18 years, below which a boy can commit any kind of brutal act and get away with it, is absolutely absurd. I don't know, if 18, why not 17, why not 16 and a half, why not 15 and a half, why not whatever. The true test is the basic test in any criminal jurisprudence, mens rea. Is there a guilty mind?
Yeah, yeah.
If there's a guilty mind, if you know what your act is, if you are aware that what you're doing is wrong, and if you do it knowing that you're doing something wrong, I do not think age counts. And especially in today's day and age, when maturity is reached so young, when youngsters are out on the streets at a very young age, behaving in all manners like an adult and insisting on being given adult rights,
yes,
to carry on with this absurd 18-year limit when somebody of 17 years, 364 days can go and commit a brutal act like this and get away like this, I think it is horrendous. And if you're asking me something on this issue today, I will say what happened today is a sad reflection not of what we did not expect, because we already knew the law. When he committed the crime and he was arrested, we already knew he was going to get away with 3 years, because we know that that is the law and that is the law which will apply to him. But what saddens me is that in all this time which has come about between then and today, we have done nothing to change the law. And that is what saddens me.
Agree with
today's
you.
Result is a natural happening pursuant to what the law
agree
is.
With you,
and that will apply to him even if the law is amended.
Agree but with you and agree with you and
to change the law.
And many apologies on getting your perspective wrong. I'm glad to hear of your own position now, and I stand corrected on that, Aryaman Sundaram. But I want to ask Kajal Menon, however strong your views are, you know, technically, Kajal, let's argue practically. Here is a fellow, a perverse mindset, a demon of a character who actually brutalized Nirbhaya after she lost consciousness. Right? And there were only two who brutalized her twice, and after she lost consciousness, this fellow is one of them. He took off her clothes, and then he got her thrown off in that state from the moving bus. Let's not argue technically. At a practical level, would you feel safe if this kind of a character was out in the streets in 2 years, which is exactly what's going to happen?
Arnob and Mr. Sundaram, you know, I wouldn't really like to get drawn by this specific case.
Why?
Because, you know, if you take on a specific case and you take on a law should be applied,
yeah,
or not applied,
not?
Or practical, because...
But this is a specific case. Nirbhaya is a specific case.
Yes, it's a specific case. And
yes,
we know one side of the story.
What is the other side of the story? What is the other side of the story?
I'm not talking about the other side of the young man right now.
Are we putting
now
a sob story here?
No,
is
I'm not
clean,
putting...
run away from a broken home,
no,
etc. kind
no,
of
no,
story?
No, I'm not putting any sob
then
story.
What
I'm trying to say is that given, and I think Mr. Sundaram put it aptly, that given the law that it exists and justice have to be, you know, meted out both to the perpetrator as well as to the victim, there was no choice. And we may dislike what the verdict has been.
Now, do you believe that you need to change the law now? Because, you know, it's completely unfair on society that we should have these people out in society.
I think
we are unwilling to wait now for decades till we feel that the juvenile justice system, etc., itself is repaired. We want an immediate correction to the problem, Kajal.
And do you think the immediate correction will happen if this gentleman is, as a lot of, is castrated or
I'm not saying castrated. I don't think
penalized.
I don't think.
Do you think every all crime will sort of end?
Well, that way, but that way, Kajal, by that logic,
will that send out a message?
No, by that logic, if we take action against all the murderers in the world, all crime will not stop. There is a possibility that a murder will happen. You know, the two accused in the Mumbai gang rape are also now claiming to be minors to escape.
Yes.
You know, this provision is being misused.
No, if you're asking...
To turn the law on its head.
No, the turn the law on its head is the question. So if you're asking, is there scope for greater debate on this issue?
Not debate, change.
Change?
Change. Immediate change.
Okay, change. No,
change.
But change does not happen. It's a nuanced, complex topic.
Why does
change
happen?
And if age of juvenility has
the threshold... We are becoming the rape capital of the world.
If the threshold has been maintained at 18, and you know...
Who? Why? The international... Why should it be 18?
There is no reason, but there has been a lot of thought that has gone into it. If you're changing it from 18 to 17 to 16 to 14...
Yeah, why don't we?
There's no reason, but we need to have a debate and a consensus over it.
Well, of course we need to have a debate, a consensus, and a change. That's what we want. We want a change. 18 is unacceptable.
No, but I think we are barking at the wrong tree.
No, we're not.
We are just looking at the easy solutions and not going saying what brings children to this. Because I have worked it's not a sob story. I think one has worked with a lot of children. On
then equally
the edge
something
of
has brought the adults to it.
Let Ariman count to you. I'm going to come back. Yes, Ariman Sundaram. Vani Tripathi also coming in. But Ariman Sundaram first. Yes, Ariman. Mr. Sundaram.
I find that this is a bit of beating around with semantics.
No.
I haven't got an answer. I heard a lot just before me. But I want to ask, do you feel 18 is correct? And do you feel that a 17 and a half year old who commits a crime like this should get away and should not be punished except for the very limited extent? Can you answer that and say, yes, I believe that even if a 17 and a half year old commits a brutal crime like this, he knows what he's doing, he's aware of it, he's an adult in all other ways, and yet he should be let off. Do you believe that? And the second issue is, the point is, we can debate all we want, but it is not a question of chronological age. It is a question of the mental intent as to whether you know what you're doing. That is a standard applied in all countries, many, many countries. Why can we not look into that standard in this country?
Because we have this oversympathetic, point of view. Let's get everyone in. Let's get everyone in. I'll come back to you. Can I just get a quick round and come back to you?
Fine.
See, the question is, I just want putting one thing in context. That the mother of one of these fellows, you know, in the Mumbai gang rape, Kasim Sheikh, also known as Kasim Bangali, has claimed that he is a minor, though he's listed in his complaint as 21. Now, I'm sorry, but in our country, you can fake anything, including a birth certificate, overnight. Right? We will have a fake certificate industry tomorrow, and any rapist who looks reasonably young will claim that he's below 18 and try and get away. And as per the preamble of the Juvenile Justice Act, it is in consonance with the UN Convention of Rights of the Child, but it does not consider mental and intellectual maturity of the child, which is envisaged in the UN Convention. It does not consider that. And
Absolutely.
We are the rape capital of the world, and this is happening. Vani Tripathi, your counter to Kajal Menon.
Well, you know, Arnab, to begin with, I'm reminded of this famous scene from a film, which created history worldwide called Silence of the Lambs, when Hannibal Lecter, the character, has been caught and the lawyer goes and says, quid pro quo. It almost looks like a quid pro quo tonight that we use the word dislike for a verdict, which is so shameful. I mean, I'm not here to criticize what the Honorable Court has said, but the fact that we are here justifying a verdict which befalls all rationale as far as not just the criminal justice system of this country is concerned, the most savage, the most heinous, and the person who did it to Nirbhaya, and the whole country was bursting at its seams, crying out aloud for justice, which was supposed to have been delivered in 3 months, now takes 8 months, and we are still yet questioning whether this is juvenile, this is not juvenile. Number two, what is the definitive reality of understanding what is juvenile? A 17 years, 3 months, 6 months, 8 year old doing a crime and a 13 year old doing a crime. Do we make that distinction when we look at jurisprudence? And when was law ever etched in stone in this country? I will remind you of the Meerut rape case, which became a landmark case as far as the rape laws of this country. Why can't Nirbhaya's case be the very instance which creates history as far as the juvenile?
Well, basically because of the human rights lobby.
Basically
because of the human rights lobby represented on the program tonight by people like Sudha Ramalingam.
Why doesn't the human rights lobby answer the human rights of this lovely, beautiful, would have been a doctor who's no more, whose life is no more, whose family is shattered?
I throw that to Sudha Ramalingam.
Where is the human rights lobby talking about human rights for the victim who's gone, who's dead, and we'll never see her again?
Where are her rights?
Where are the rights of the victim? Where are the rights of the women in this country?
Sudha Ramalingam, respond please. Why do you have such a one-sided view
of
things?
Which is called the rape capital of the country.
Sudha Ramalingam, why do you have such a one-sided view of things?
I'm not having a one-sided view. I think, Arnab, you have a one-sided view of all human rights activists. That's your problem. Your problem is to sensitize things and not really think of law as it has to be administered. Justice has to be administered as per law. You can have your laws amended if need be, and we are not there to say that this should only be the law. We are here to say that it should be just humane. You are the one who just now told that every paper could be forged in this country. You are the one who just now a little while ago said you can get any birth certificate, and in a country where you can get anything, you can also accuse a person, arrest a person tomorrow, even you could be held up for rape. You know that could be a false complaint against you by any of your own colleagues, and what will you do? On that day you will think of all our human rights activists. You will not then be talking about anything else other
what
than
does that have to do with juveniles?
Also the law
no,
being
you don't understand
abused, the law being
no, you're not understanding the argument.
People, you are deemed innocent.
Okay, Vani,
don't keep calling and keep on accusing us.
No, nobody is accusing you.
Arnab, this is a fantastic argument to give. Arnab, this is a fantastic argument to give to talk about sensitization. Who are the human rights activists and sensitizing at the end of the day? Are they creating sensitivity for a young, impressionable life who's gone? Are they creating sensitivity? Imagine, Mrs. Ramalingam, answer this question when 3 years later, this boy who's probably 20 years old is out on the streets. Will you feel safe with your daughter? Will you feel safe with your sister? Will you feel safe? Are you going to sensitize society towards him and say no, he has done it once, he won't do it again? Are you going to look at the correction system of what the mindset which creates rape in society? Are you ready to put yourself on the anvil and answer that?
You see, Ms. Sudha Ramalingam, you're unnecessarily...
Yes, I am ready to answer.
No, Ms. Sudha Ramalingam, Sudha Ramalingam, Ms. Ramalingam, 1 minute. Ms. Ramalingam.
The person could be reformed.
Ms. Ramalingam, I know that you have great fondness for me. This debate is not about me. I know your love and affection for me. I reciprocate. The question is very simple. And I throw it as a challenge to you and to Kajal Menon. My question is as a challenge, and I'm letting Kajal Menon answer that, and then Rahul Narvekar will come in. I am asking, I am not an anti-human rights activist, and I'm certainly not a lawyer or politician.
You're becoming an anti-human rights activist.
No, I'm not an anti-human rights activist. All I'm saying is, should the severity of the crime be of no consequence in such cases? Shouldn't there be some room for discretion instead of a blanket rule? One second. My challenge to you is, and I'm throwing to Kajal, and then I'm going to come get a response from Rahul Narvekar. Does it not seem ridiculous to you, Kajal, that a boy who picks pockets and the rapist murderer in Nirbhaya are subjected to the same law? You pick a pocket, or you are a rapist murderer, you are subjected to the same law. Maximum 3 years in a reform home. Kajal, answer.
Absolutely.
That.
But I'm just responding back to, I can really empathize with the agitation of Vani and the public mood that is there. But, you know, there is worry if you are going to get hooked in and pulled in by the emotion of the moment and change laws, change what has been thought through to a certain extent.
Change it.
Without a consultation. Nobody's
what
saying don't change it. Nobody's
moment.
Saying Vani or Mr. Sundaram. Mr. Sundaram is a lawyer out there. And I think nobody stopped him for agitating for change in law. But let's go by a process to find out what should be done. It can't be done on a TV studio.
No, but where will it be done?
Why don't we take...
Where will it be done?
One second.
Where will it be done?
Why don't we take... Can I just finish,
Vani? Why can't it be done?
Please.
What is the emotion of the moment all about?
Vani, can I just finish?
The emotion of the moment, something the whole country
Vani, can I just finish,
to and not just the country.
Because if you...
You saw... No, just a minute, Kajal ji, please.
No, can I just finish my point?
I need to understand this emotion of the moment business.
Can we use the same emotion? Can we use this? Yes, the same.
Is this the emotion of the moment that we are talking about? Or are we talking about jurisprudence in this country? Are we talking about protection of women in this country? Are we talking about...
We are also talking about protection of children, Vani.
Children, this fellow is not a child.
One second. Yes,
what is the definition of a child?
Children is important.
What is the definition of a child, Kajal?
Not going to let me...
Not the way
that you are suggesting.
Let Kajal complete. Rahul hasn't come in yet.
How is it reformative? You tell me... Something savagery of this order,
yeah.
Savagery of this order, you are actually planning to reform it, keeping
Vani?
It in a home where probably the person does not have access to also psychological counseling on a per day basis.
Vani,
I mean, what are we talking about
Vani,
here? When
I
you talk about protection of child rights,
all I'm saying,
what is which will protect the children of this country,
Vani,
including the girl
child? What I'm saying is, let's leverage on this public outrage to see that the protection system is enhanced in the country. I stand for that.
Yeah, so
you know, there is an act that has been enacted and a scheme 4 years back, the ICPS. With the under-resource, with the way the juvenile justice homes are there, I agree with you. When the young man goes in, is he going to get reformed and come?
So he's not going to get reformed? So
it's a question in my mind.
So one sec. So
it's
one,
a question,
the question
in my mind,
mind
that it...
No,
it,
if you... No, I'll tell you.
Given
exactly
what the thing...
The
but let's use this, Vani.
Let's use this to create the public pressure
to look at administration to improve the protection.
Yes, we will.
But just by hanging, just by taking on one case, I don't think it's going to happen.
No. One sec. I'll get Rahul Nadvekar in because he hasn't spoken yet. But at this point, we need to also keep one thing in mind. This juvenile justice law was made many years back. Now, we have become the rape capital of the world. And let me also say that the number of sexual offences in which juveniles are involved has been on a serious rise in the last 10 years.
Sorry, I want to correct you.
The
National Crime Report Bureau clearly says that is no more than 32,000 out of a 1.25 billion. So this kind of
those figures are there, and I challenge your interpretation of the figures.
No, those figures
Kajal, with great respect to you, I challenge your interpretation of the figures, because as per the Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation, that out of the number of juveniles arrested in 2010, there were 12.12% who were repeat offenders. 1 minute. In 2011, 11.5% are repeat offenders. Close to 22% of all juvenile criminals in Delhi were repeat offenders, in contrast to the national average of 11.2%.
No.
I'm saying repeat offenders, which means the possibility, Kajal, the possibility that fellow who did the rape will go back out there and commit another rape and commit another murder or try to do it is pretty high, one out of five. And I don't want to live with that risk.
Yeah.
I don't want to live with that risk.
Let's create a better protection system.
Well, I can't wait for that. I want.
And you think just hanging this?
I'm not saying hanging. I'm saying don't let him off.
Don't let him off.
What's the definition of a child?
The moment we use this generic term, protection of child rights, what are we actually getting into? I worked at the National School of Drama with children for a very long time. What kind of protection of child rights are we defining?
I'm asking Rahul as I join Rahul into this very important debate. What about everybody's talking about what should be done for that? You know, I am not one of those.
Child's rights. We are talking about a child who's committed a crime.
Exactly.
What are we talking about? Child's rights.
Yes.
We are all for child's rights. You see, I'm talking about what do you do with somebody who's 17 and a half years old who escapes the magic figure by 6 months and commits a dastardly crime. What do you do with him? What does that have to do with child's rights?
Precisely. Why haven't you pushed it, Mr. Sundaram, towards with legal battle? What were the 7 or 8 months that were there? What was the advocacy you were doing towards this?
Those 7 or 8 months, unfortunately, when the hands of a parliament,
human rights lobby has such a influence?
And doesn't get on with their work in parliament.
No, let's keep one point very clear. Everybody's talking about what should be done to the rapist.
Yes.
One sec. I am asking here today, what about the children? What about women? What about potential victims? In our country, I'm sorry, I'm not among those politically correct journalists who are only going to say the politically correct thing. I'm going to say, what about children? What about girls? Absolutely. What about women out there who feel vulnerable? What about their rights?
Absolutely.
And by the way, I would like to tell you, you consider the juvenile system in France. Let me get Rahul Narvekar in. We are looking at other countries. France considers a person to be liable for crimes when they're capable of discernment. In other words, when they can make out. Now,
absolutely.
I don't want to go by a technical definition of child, which means 17 years and 364 days child, 18 years and 1 day adult, which means 17 years, 364 days, you can't discern that you're committing a rape and murder. 18 years, 1 year, 1 day, you suddenly become capable of understanding that you're carrying out a rape and murder. I reject that point of view. But Rahul, you've heard all sides tonight. Where do you stand? Rahul, take a position on this.
Well, Arnab, most of the time on your debate has been consumed by the honorable ladies on the show. I guess they believe that this issue is a lady-centric issue or a female-centric issue,
that.
Which I totally believe it is not. It's a society issue of the entire society. But on a lighter note, but coming to the crux of the issue, I also appreciate your cynicism, but I firmly believe that we are not the rape capital of the world. I just believe that we are a conscious society with a vibrant media which is no longer willing to take down such assaults on women lightly. So let's keep it at that. Insofar as the current issue is concerned, see, the Juvenile Justice Act, we need to go down to the object of this act. The object of this act was to give benefit to the minor age of the child, to give benefit of the immature age of the child. But a child who acts in a manner in which this accused has act or this convict has acted, who definitely had complete mens rea in his mind and also could act in a manner in which he did, certainly cannot be termed as immature or didn't know what he was doing. Therefore, I do not think that we should assess a person to be a juvenile based on his age, but we need to assess it on the basis of the crime that he commits. And rightly said by Mr. Rama Sundaram,
but
that mens rea is an essential criteria which has to be dealt with. And at the same time, I think this argument about human rights, etc., absolutely holds no ground in the current case, for the simple reason that a person who violates somebody else's right cannot seek human right as a defense. So I think this is something which we need to deal with. And this whole act, Juvenile Justice Act, to my mind, has become the very reason for people committing such crimes, because they know that what's going to happen. At the most, they're going to get 3 years. So it's no more a deterrent. In fact, it's adding on to the crime that's prevailing in our society.
And we stick out like a sore thumb in terms of how impractical we are in the application.
I will argue with you on any of those.
Can I add one thing here?
Mr. Sundaram,
can I add one thing here?
Let Mr. Sundaram make his point and come to you. Yes, Mr. Sundaram.
Just one thing. You know what I do find is a danger? That if once you have a cutoff date like 18 years and you have somebody who still can discern that they're doing a wrong act, please see also where it puts that child, since those people who are talking about child's rights. Do you know any gangs, anybody, will try to coerce children of 17 and a half years to get into crime and to take, for example, being courier of drugs, of being people who do the break-in, who do the crime? They will use these children knowing that this is a least punishment area. These children are not really going to get punished. They will tempt the children to do so. You can get more people
That's
into
right.
crime.
They're
I
doing
think
it
we
all
must
the time,
have
Mr.
the
Sundaram.
Rules same as in France. And are you old
terrorist
enough to
Terrorist attacks
crime?
Are constantly doing it, using children.
So then why? No, what's it? This is not, this, once it, this is not, once it, this is not a situation where a child is being used. You know, I'm sorry, Kajal. I
no,
don't
no.
believe in this overly
have,
sympathetic
no,
situations
no,
which
have
you
no
create.
Sympathy
where a child is the product of their circumstances, must be coming from a terrible social milieu, is the product of a society that has not, you know, let them flower, has got the wrong things in our head. And, you know, let me tell you this,
no.
all children from those backgrounds are not murderers and rapists. So let us
Absolutely
not try and draw
not.
That
I don't
generalization.
Think I've even
and that's my problem.
Those things.
That's my problem with the human rights lobby represented by Sudha Ramalingam tonight.
And I think
where,
we
there
are
is, where there is
putting labels and
well, it is
add one thing. The senior counsel does not speak about the safety homes or place of safety to which these juveniles can be sent. They are not; they need not be sent to the special homes wherein other juveniles are kept. They could be given all special treatment and psychiatric counselling and other counselling kept under one probationary officer and ensure that.
Ma'am, why are we?
Report.
Why do we have a warped idea of the definition of juvenile?
You mean that
sorry,
17 years, 364 days?
One second, Ariman Sundaram is countering you. Ariman Sundaram, go ahead.
1 day on a different.
Ariman Sundaram, go ahead.
No.
The junior, juvenile can be...
I want to only ask one thing. You talk about a special place. Can I answer you? You talk about being put in a special place, being given special treatment, everything. I fully agree. Every criminal should be given some kind of psychiatric help on the presumption that he is psychiatric.
I don't speak about it.
But the fact is something else. Here is somebody who's 17 years and very close to 18, who commits a heinous crime, he should be given special treatment. Somebody else who's 1 month older commits the same crime and need not be given special treatment. The fact is, look at the crime, look at the mind behind the crime, look at the intention behind the crime, and punish the crime for the crime committed.
No, you see the what? The UN, the
it's
UN prescription.
Another important question. Another important question. Which could be put up tonight.
An amendment to the law.
No, what amendment to the law? What amendment? We have already misinterpreted the law. Sudha Ramalingam. No. Sudha Ramalingam. Sudha Ramalingam. Sudha Ramalingam. Miss Ramalingam. Ma'am, please listen to me.
As a mensria and intention, we should also segregate
and
ensure that there could be some other ways of punishing, which should be actually discussed and the law amended
please,
if need be.
Please understand.
But Justice Verma
please understand the basic. No. Are you saying? Are you saying there is any possibility? Let me ask you and Kajal both. Are you saying there is any possibility, Kajal, that the fellow who did this, that demon who did this, was not conscious of what he was doing? Because the UN prescription on what is a juvenile keeps in mind emotional, mental and intellectual maturity. Why are all those, and I'm sorry you'll say again, I'm classifying all activists slash human rights activists
no,
of the view.
Do not classify, that, please.
No, but there's a classification is happening. That's the position that all activists are taking on this, that you need to have an 18-year-old classification.
No, I
Our
do
system,
not say that.
No, all across the world, it's being brought down to 16
yeah.
or 15. In some cases, you know, in other cases, even after 14 or 15, provided you are a discerning individual, you are held liable for your crime.
I'm okay Why? With all of that, or no, Mr. Sundaram, Vani, whoever is taking those positions, or Mr. Narvekar, bring it down, calibrate the punishments. There are two issues. One is the law as it exists.
Yes.
Justice, how it has to be applied.
The law is inadequate.
Maybe.
The law is inadequate.
Then, let's change it. That's a different matter.
Change it.
When I am talking about this issue, the issue why we are getting agitated is because we bring in the specificity of this case.
Of course, we'll pick up.
One second.
The entire debate in this country is around Nirbhaya.
No, because if you take one case.
Why is the specificity so
scary? Can I just complete, Vani? I don't think I intervene when you're speaking.
Not important. No, Kajal ji, no, we need to resolve this because this debate is not going to end. Is
because
the mental health more important of a person who's involved in a crime or is it the chronological?
One is not saying that, but you're not willing to listen.
And also this needs to be answered. Why? I mean, when was the rape?
Okay, one more minute on the debate. Let her complete. Let her complete, then I'm taking Rahul in.
Why don't we resolve?
Okay.
Why don't we resolve?
Kajal, complete your point. Closing comments from Rahul.
A rarest, rare crime.
Of course.
Why is it not important as a context?
Of course it's a rarest of rare crime, and that's why we need to use this opportunity.
I think the legal system has to
answer to that, why there has not been mens rea, why do they follow the juvenile justice, why do we not take on every case by what the public mood is, why don't we bend it accordingly?
Is that a valid
argument? Those are issues that can be done. Why don't we take on the positives from this case? Why are we fighting shy of taking these emotions and saying what are we doing for the children of this country to protect them? Forget this young man who's 17 years old. Why are we not answering those questions?
Rahul Narvekar is closing the debate by responding to Kajol Menon.
Young politicians, why are we not taking this as an issue? Without a doubt, I can tell you that
the Juvenile Justice Act is quite an old piece of legislation, certainly needs an amendment, keeping in mind the changing values in the society, the changing aspects of the society. I think this legislation certainly needs an amendment, and more so with the world dealing with this issue in a different manner and a more practical manner. I think we need to pick up a clue from that and get an amendment to this act. And certainly this will help the society.
Well, I think it can be a starting point, Kajol. We need to start some difficult questions. As an administrator, an amendment may not change everything.
An amendment will certainly reduce the burden on this society.
I say the anything better
and
than
you
the
don't
status
think
quo.
The protection of all the other young people who are there, who are living on the edge of society, and we ignore them throughout when we meet them at the railway station, and when they commit heinous crimes, we are ready. Is that not a hypocrisy of us as a community and as a country?
I'm closing the debate because I'm short of time. All I'd say is anything but the status quo. Let the debate begin. Let the debate continue. Anything but the status quo. Thank you very much for joining me in debate number 2 tonight. Thank you. Thank you very much.